What is going on, everybody? I hope you guys are all having a fantastic day. Today, we're going to be going over the 3 best ways to win gunfights in Modern Warfare 2. I feel like after playing Modern Warfare 2 for so many days now, the game is obviously a lot different than what we are used to, right? We're so used to the slide cancel era of Call of Duty. You know, you're used to engaging a lot differently. But what I've noticed in Modern Warfare 2 is that you're actually going to want to stray away from a lot of those bad habits, is what I would like to call them, because you basically die in one bullet and there's no advanced movement to slide cancel anymore. Everything's a little bit more clunky, you know? Everything doesn't feel as smooth, and that's something I want to talk to you guys about today. So let's go ahead and get right into it. The first thing is first is we're going to be talking about jump shotting corners. In previous titles, you could do this, but it really maybe wasn't the best way to engage. You would usually do like a slide cancel movement or something along those lines just to kind of switch it up and help break your opponent's camera. But in Modern Warfare 2, jump shotting corners is literally the best way to engage. And what I mean by that is if you were to come up here and slow peek this corner, right, it gives your enemy a huge advantage. If he's already sitting here pre-aiming the head glitch and you just slow peek the corner, he's going to be ready for you in 2 seconds. Whereas if you jump the corner, now he doesn't know exactly how far you were going to be going when you engage in that gunfight. So something I've been getting used to, and obviously since they removed the bunny hop, is making sure when you jump shot corners, you're just predicting exactly where your opponent could be, just because that will help you so much. Because the time to kill Modern Warfare 2, like I said, is so fast. If you're not ready for a gunfight or you slow peek an angle, you are going to die to that enemy 9 out of 10 times. So it's something that you have to add to your gameplay. And usually a lot of players would say that this is really a scuff mechanic or a Battle Beaver mechanic, where you kind of have to have an advanced controller. And that is what I have. I do have a Battle Beaver controller that basically has 2 buttons on the back. If you guys don't know what that is, it basically allows you to jump, aim, and shoot all at once without having to take my finger ever off of the right thumbstick, so I can continuously aim. I know a lot of you may not have that, but there are different settings you can change. I know you can put on bumper jumper to allow you to be able to do this. That way you are not sitting there stuck, you know, switching your thumbstick. So basically what it would look like is you'd run around the corner, jump, and then you'd have to move it with, you'd hit X, and then you'd have to move your thumbstick, which makes it a lot harder to engage in these gunfights. But you guys need to add this tactic to your gameplay. I promise you it will help you guys out so much, winning every gunfight and just kind of predicting where your opponent could be. It's kind of trial and error, right? You're going to get used to the predictable spots that people like to sit in. For instance, if I'm jumping this corner here, I usually know people like to play up on this balcony. So instead of pre-aiming low, I'm going to scan that and then I'm going to switch to top. That way I have an idea of where my opponents are. I'm guessing and you know, ready for the next gunfight. That way if they are there, I'm not coming around the corner like this, literally just waiting to die. If I do that, I'm dead 10 out of 10 times. If I do this, I can actually win the gunfight. This is just a tactic that you have to get down in Modern Warfare 2. Otherwise, you're really not going to enjoy yourselves that much. But you always just want to keep your gun up, because again, it would allow you to win so many more gunfights, because the time to kill in Modern Warfare 2 is so fast. You can't run around like a headless chicken, you know, just sprinting around, hoping you get gunfights. There's no slide canceling. There's nothing like that. Out with the old, in with the new, and definitely get this jump shotting corners habit down. The next way that I want to talk to you guys about engaging is drop shotting. There's this mechanic called the instant drop shot. And basically what that means is on your screen, it doesn't look anything crazy, but let me tell you, on the enemy's screen, it looks absolutely insane. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want a tactical sprint and then instantly drop shot. Pull back on your left stick, drop shot. Pull back on your left stick, drop shot. And it's almost like a snaking mechanic, but it looks insane on the enemy's POV. And if I can go dive to one of these bots, I can show you guys exactly what I mean. But it's literally crazy. Like, you literally basically drop and hit the floor instantly. The instant drop shot, basically, you see how fast I instantly hit the floor. This is huge for engaging. So if I'm coming around a corner or I know a guy's in a tunnel, you basically tack sprint forward, like I said, pull back on your left stick and drop. And it doesn't look fast on your screen, like I was saying, but on the enemy's screen, it literally looks like you belly flop on the ground instantaneously. This is huge to catch your opponents off guard, especially because, like, let's say I come around this corner, right, and I'm pre-aiming high, but you're already on the belly. My gun is going to block my vision. So I'm not even going to be able to see you if you get on the floor. Again, this is kind of an advanced movement tactic. You're definitely going to have to get used to it. It's not an easy one for you to just pull over, you know, one night and just get used to. So definitely practice this. This helps if you put on automatic tactical sprint as well. That way you can already have that momentum. And then you pull back on your left stick, like I said, to stop the tack sprint. And then you instantly, whatever your prone button is, drop shot. This again will catch your opponents off guard 9 out of 10 times, and it will find yourself getting a lot of kills. Maybe like you're one shot, you think you have no chance in the gunfight, you end up drop shotting, and now you get another 2 kills, then regen and continue to go from there. So I would definitely add this movement mechanic into your gameplay. Like I said, I think this is a huge way to engage. Since there is no slide canceling, you know, obviously we have to switch it up and add more advanced movement tactics. That way we can continue to absolutely fry and add a little bit of a So a little bit of a skill gap in the game. Go ahead and add this to your gameplay. Thirdly, and the most important, is going to be snaking. You guys have all known this. This has been a thing for COD forever and ever and ever. For all you bots out there who struggle to get kills, and like I said, slow peek angles, make sure you stop doing this. Please, 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 please. If you want to improve, I have people come to my stream all the time saying, hey, how can I improve? How do I get better? What can I do better? It's called snaking, okay? Put on automatic tactical sprint and do this. Don't stand on your head glitch. Stop. Stop just standing here. You're asking to die. Unless you have the whole entire lane cut or something like that, and you have a guaranteed gunfight, start snaking. Snaking is broken. It's a broken mechanic, and the devs need to fix it. Basically, you just bob and weave tactic. The enemy can never see you. They can't shoot at you, and you'll win every gunfight. You're just going to want to add this to your gameplay, whether it's snaking a head glitch that you're already on, whether you're just bob and weaving on a head glitch, whether you're aimed in or not. Just stop standing there, standing still, unless, again, you have the whole angle cut, because this will help you win so many more gunfights. It'll help your opponent not slow peek you with a sniper, get early information on you. You can also get information without being weak. And again, this is going to just help you prepare for another gunfight, win another gunfight, whatever it may be. It's going to help you so much. So just try and get used to it. Again, with automatic tactical sprint, it's basically how to do it is you just sprint over and over, up and down. And then it's the same thing with like pulling back on your stick. So you're just sprinting, pulling back. And you're crouching in there the whole time. And again, this will allow you to get information on your opponents without taking damage. And then if they do try and push you, like let's say somebody's trying to hit mid on me, I'm going to be ready for that gunfight. Pull up my gun, bang, kill, no problem at all. So you guys, again, snaking is probably the last thing that I would tell you guys to win gunfights. But if you guys can add all three of these things to your gameplay, I promise you, you will find yourself winning so many more gunfights. Again, Modern Warfare 2 is a new engine. We're out with the old, man. We're done with slide canceling, done with all this old, you know, advanced movement, and it's time to switch things up. So I would definitely add jump shot in corners. This is huge. Again, best way to engage, focusing on that centering with that. Then go ahead and add the prone drop shot. I think that's huge. It's again a broken movement mechanic, and until it gets fixed, you guys definitely need to be using it. Then lastly, go ahead and add in the snaking. Snaking is insane. It's a great way to engage, like I said, in Modern Warfare 2, and it'll help you win a lot more gunfights. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to smash that like button, tag a friend who needs some help winning some gunfights, and comment down below what other types of videos you guys would like to see. Make sure to hit that subscribe button as well, and until the next video, guys, I'll see you guys later. Peace!